Fire Nation, as we welcome the 2021 state champion boys cross country team, led by Coach Rill. Hey, everybody knows the words. All right, so now that we can put some faces to the state championship, let's give them another big, huge round of applause. These are your boys' cross-country champions. Led by Coach Rill, all the way down on that end. And if you walk down the hallway before you get into the Fieldhouse gym, you'll see a young Coach Rill's picture right up there. He was a state champion at Fenwick High School, class of 87. Two-time. Were you All-American too? And All-American, sorry. He's All-World. He's done it all. All right. It's my pleasure to introduce first, before we introduce Coach Rill, a friend of mine and somebody that I think broke two of my ribs hugging me last Saturday, Coach Dan Winneck.
Thank you. But it's them, not me. It's them. One more round of applause for them, please. Thank you. I'd like to begin by acknowledging some of the successes we've had thus far in the fall. First of all, soccer had a great season, Sweet 16, I believe. Volleyball, girls volleyball made it to regional championship games. They were regional championships, made it to sectionals. How can we forget girls state for our girls tennis, third in state? Boys golf, regional champs with Nick Scudder competing at state. Girls golf, regional champs as well. Lillian and Charlotte Bateman competing at state. And then girls cross country. They had a little surprise in the middle of the season. Coach Roach's baby came a little early. But she's all healthy. Baby Grace is at home now. They had a great season as well. We got to give some props to Coach Collins, Coach Romero, and Brother Trout. They stepped up in the absence of Coach Roach, and they were able to have a great season as well. Bella Daly, 23rd at state, all state, and Ava Martinez made it down state as well. I've got to be honest with you. We had the privilege of watching Bella and Ava run at state right before our guys warmed up, and I think that really served as a motivating factor for us because we were able to get inspired by their great performances at state. And then last but not least, of course, football is still going on, so Let's do what we do on Saturday versus NAS, and then swimming, I believe, has three relays and three individuals going downstate for girls. So good luck to everybody. Okay, now some thank yous. First of all, thank you to Father Petticord, all the way to top, for supporting us all this time. Thank you to Mr. Groom and Mr. Thies and Tracy Bonacorsi. Thank you very much for being there at state for us. It was so nice to have representation there from Mr. Groom and Mr. Thies. I would also like to thank Mr. Beto Garcia for organizing that walkout that we did last week. That was awesome. And then Mr. Gallo, our number one fan, I would say. How can you go wrong with Mr. Gallo? The last person I would like to acknowledge is a gentleman sitting all the way in the back. Mr. Polka, if you could stand up or maybe raise your hand. Many of you don't know Mr. Polka, but Mr. Polka taught here for 52 years. He retired in 2017. In 1966, he started the cross-country program and coached it until 2009 when he gave it over to Coach Rill, who was one of his best runners. So this cross-country team is his baby. We just took it over and we nurtured it. Just so you know, a few more things about Mr. Polka. He was inducted into the Catholic League Coaches Hall of Fame in 1991, Illinois Track and Cross Country Coaches Association Hall of Fame in 2001, and he's been officiating the state meet since 1972. And so we were super fortunate to have him down there at state watching his team win the state title. And something that many of you might not know, when we finished the award ceremony, we were given an extra medal, first place medal. And we kind of, the coaches and I got together and we said, who do we give this to? And then Mr. Polka walked by and it's like, of course, Mr. Polka. And so it was an amazing, amazing moment. The only thing that could match the elation of winning was presenting that medal to Coach Polka because he truly deserves it. So, yeah, all a round of applause for Mr. Polka. All right, a couple more things. This week, cross country was popular in my classes. Students were asking how cross country works and how it becomes a team score. So let me just explain that to everybody just a little bit. So, when we compete, we have seven runners. The top five runners from each team add to the total score of the team. The place you finish in a race equals the amount of points that you add to the team score. So for example, if we have a runner finishing in fifth place, that's 5 points. If another runner finishes in 15th place, that's 15 points for a total of 20. And you do that with runners 3, 4, and 5, and the lowest score wins. So just to give you an idea, at state, we scored 121 points or 20? 120 points. The second place team was 141, and then the third place team was 165 or 164. And so that's how we became state champs. The other question that I have is, how fast do they run and how does it feel when they run? So all of them are running around 15 minutes for 3 miles, so about 5 minutes per mile. Our top guys at state went out in about 4:45. And then they got to keep up that pace for another 2 miles. And so the other question was, how does it feel when you run? And the only thing I could explain, and maybe you guys will agree with me, but when you're running a cross country race, it feels like you're at war. On one side, you've got your body telling you, stop, you're an idiot, this hurts, don't do this anymore, your legs hurt, you can't breathe. And then on the other side, you've got your mind telling you, keep going. This is what you trained for. And so whether you run a good race or a bad race, a lot of times depends on who wins. If the body wins, you're probably going to slow down. But if the mind wins, you're probably going to have a good race. And this is why you see them collapsing at the finish line, because when they cross the finish line, they know the body is still tired and the mind says, okay, I've done my job, I'm out. And then the body takes over and they collapse. That's what happened with Nate. We were trying to find him for a half an hour after the state meet, and apparently he was puking somewhere by a tree. We're afraid that he's going to miss the award ceremony. So if you're interested in feeling like absolute crap, the worst you've ever felt for 15 minutes in your life, followed by the best you felt for the next week, you know, come out for cross country and we'll show you how that feels. And then finally, last but not least, I would love to thank all of you parents for all your support. None of this can be done without you. All the alums of the program that I know are watching right now, you know who I'm talking about. All the former coaches, yes, including Mr. McKinley, you all had a part in building this program since 1966 when Mr. Polka started. Okay, so now to the man who's responsible for most of this team's success, head coach Dave Rill.
All right, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to introduce the team. I'm not going to talk as long as Mr. Winnick, but I just wanted to so you guys know who these guys are and some of our coaches that you don't know. First of all, I just want to, Mr. Gallo made me sound way better than I was. I took second only once, so I didn't win state twice, but that's okay. it made me sound really good. So I'm going to introduce you. I'm going to go from the end here. Assistant coach Brixton Rill. Put your hand up when you get there. Assistant coach Gus Coronado. We got senior Lee O'Brien. Junior Chris Beta. Senior Finley Huggins. We have a freshman on the team. It's Finn Munley. Senior Zach Daly. Senior Jonathan Mahomes. Junior Michael Domke. Sophomore Christian Klein. Senior Carl Lucas.
They love the school. I said that all at once.
Sophomore Dean O'Brien. Our next runner is, he was 20th, right? 20th place, All-State, and that's Nate McKillop. And then the last one here is, he was 8th at State, making him All-State also. Junior, that's Graydon Rill. So I'll be very brief. I'm just going to talk about the season real quick, how it went. We started out the season, I think we were ranked like 10th, and we didn't want to be ranked at all. We kind of like to fly under the radar. Within a couple meets, we were beating a bunch of 3A schools, which is, you know, the bigger schools, the Yorks, the Hinsdale Centrals, those schools. So we immediately jumped up to, I believe it was first at that point. We held that spot for a few weeks. We bounced down to second, ranked second. Yeah, we lost to the second-ranked team. But then after that, they bumped us up going into the state series to rank number one again. So it was fun. Some of the things we really enjoyed at the Chicago Catholic League meet, we were down our number one runner, and we still beat two schools that I know everybody here doesn't like a whole lot. That's St. Ignatius and Loyola. So from that point on, so we won CCLs, we were regional champs, sectional champs, and then state champions. So at this point, I believe Mr. Gallo's coming back up.
All right, at this time, Father Petticord and Mr. Groom, if you could come on up, and we can officially present the trophy. so it can get put in, you know, in the atrium for a long time. So let's hear it one more time for the cross country team state champions. Congratulations. Okay, and I know that Mr. Groom wanted to make some comments here.
So, while Mr. Gallo talked about the numerous state championships that we've won, countless have been in the swimming pool. We've won a couple on ice, and we've won a couple on the basketball court. But we have never, ever won a state championship on land. This is the first state championship we have ever won on land. So back many years ago when we were winning in the pool quite regularly, we ended up having a policy where we had days off for state championships for seasons. Okay, and I was wondering, do we do this as a season and wait to see what happens, or do these boys deserve a day off? Do you all deserve a day off in honor of these boys? So, I was actually wondering what your reaction would be to that question. And it sounds like you do want a day off. So in light of that, December 13th, a Monday, we will be celebrating an all-school holiday, and it'll be a three-day weekend. So, to those that are competing this weekend, good luck. Make sure, seniors especially, you set an example, behave well at the events that we do have. And Mr. Galler, are we passing it back off to you now? Okay, thank you very much.
All right, just one quick comment, you know, talking about land. I think there's a piece of land out in LaGrange Park that maybe we're going to go take over on this Saturday afternoon. So, you know, I can get really comfortable emceeing a whole bunch of these, you know, this year. So, you know, football team, girls swimming, don't forget about Santino Ori and the hockey team on Friday night against Ignatius. So, just one real last quick cheer, and then we'll start the fight song. And then we're all excited, most of all, about going to our 11th period classes. Yeah! Oh, sorry. The captains are going to make a quick comment. Sorry about that.
Yeah! All right, how is everybody today? Yeah? Yeah! Okay, so the first thing I want to say, this is probably the most surreal moment of my life ever. When it, girls hockey, they won state, I remember having this that assembly for them, and I was sitting back there, and I was like, wow, that would be so cool to be up on that stage one day. I never thought it would happen, but here I am today on the stage! So this is to all the underclassmen. Never believe that you can't win a state. You put in the focus. You put in the hard work. You can be up on this stage. There's nothing stopping you except yourself. We have some of the greatest coaches at Fenwick, and if you listen to your coach, I promise you, you could be up here. And so what Coach Winnek was saying about when you're running and it hurts so much and you're just want to just lay on the floor and cry almost sometimes, you think, why am I doing this? We do this for our teammates. One special teammate, Mikey Domke, he's, I don't know if you can see this right now, he's got a broken leg boot. This kid has gone through every injury, but he still tries harder than everybody else. So much respect for Mikey. Let's hear it for Mikey. And the other team, or the other group of people that we're running for, is you guys, Fire Nation! We put it all on the line for you guys. We push ourselves to puke. We push ourselves to collapse. We push ourselves to pass out. Anything for Fire Nation! Thank you, guys. You guys are the best school in the world.
Thank you very much. Is the microphone on? Can you hear me? One real quick thing. This is truly an all-school celebration. There is freshmen, sophomores, juniors, and seniors. All four classes participated. That's a really unusual thing to have happen. And a lot of these runners are coming back. But I want to call up one of my, I remember the first cross country event I ever went to. I walked up to him and he's like, "Hey, Mr. Gill." And I didn't even really know him that well, but he came up and he hugged me. And I want to have him lead us in the fight song. And that is Zach Daly. So Zach, all you got to do is just go bump, 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 bump. All right, everybody up. Ready?
March, Fenwick, march down the field. March, Fenwick. We conquer our foes and kill fight for our foes. Black and white. And for Fenwick and victory.
All right. All right, everybody. I believe that concludes our event. We will see you hopefully back here in 3 weeks after the boys tackle Nazareth and whoever else is waiting down the road in football. Don't forget about boys hockey and the girls swim team on Saturday.
Let's celebrate.